welcome you back to Miami. Another important stop along the drive to the national championship. And as we go down to our colleague Lisa Salters, note that we do not have the skinned infield here tonight. Lisa, looks beautiful there.
That's right, Brent. The entire field was re-sodded this week. Not just the baseball diamond part that was left over from the Florida Marlins, but the entire field. The old grass was taken out on Tuesday. The new sod laid down on Wednesday and Thursday. This is custom-grown stuff, grown in Alabama at the Bent Oaks Turf Farm. It's a sand-based sod, which is better for drainage, good because of all the heavy rain they get here in South Florida. No rain expected tonight, though, which is, of course, good for me. Brent, this is the first time that this field will have been played on, but it will be re-sodded right before they play Super Bowl 44 here on February 7th. Brent.
And Lisa, just as soon as we finish tonight, that you will be cut out of the center of the field and replaced by the Miami Dolphins logo. Tomorrow afternoon, they have a game here against the Buffalo Bills. Well, Miami won the toss, and they will receive, electing to handle the football right away. As you see, and Herbie, great resume on both sides here.
Well, you think about the mid-80s and into the 90s, Oklahoma and Miami, so many great championship caliber teams. It's always exciting to see Miami with their history and tradition going up against the Oklahoma Sooners.
Coach Bob Stoops anxiously prowling that sideline as we get ready to go here. His team will be on defense against Randy Shannon's offense. Cooper. Hole in the middle to the 29-yard line, and that's where we will see Ja'Cory Harris here at the start of this game.
Now the big sophomore, 6'4", 190 pounds. Of course, last week, the Canes offense struggled. I found it interesting. They won the toss, and they want to get the football back to their offense, and they want to try to establish a rhythm. The most important thing is balance within this offense tonight, slowing down a very dominant Oklahoma defensive front.
Mike James is the offset fullback, and that is Javaris James behind him in the tailback spot. The James game and Tavares to the 35-yard line, and Herbie, our impact player.
You just saw one of them, Javaris James. He's been around for a long time, and he and Craig Cooper give them a great 1-2 punch in the backfield. Keep an eye on Cooper tonight, not only running the football. Miami likes to try to isolate the linebackers and throw the ball to number two, and then Travis Benjamin leads a host of very talented wide receivers for this Miami Y offense that Ja'Cory Harris will be looking to get the football to.
Second and five, and they put it back in James' hands in the stout middle of that Oklahoma defensive line. Reynolds, the middle linebacker, helping out to end that play. This will be a tough front seven to run against here tonight.
These linebackers are already attacking downhill, which tells you the importance of what we talked about, play action, trying to do anything you can to slow down Travis Lewis and Brian Reynolds and Keenan Clayton, the entire linebacker crew there. They're very, very aggressive.
Trying to get set up, and they've got to use a timeout. The Hurricanes burn one here early as they seem confused with the formation of the play that the assistant coach Whipple wanted run. And so, Herbie, what's the over-under on the number of times that I mentioned Brett Favre here tonight?
I'm going to say eight.
Oh, I'm
eight,
going
two
way,
a quarter. You're going way over?
Way over that.
Okay. What a showdown Monday night.
That is something, isn't it? So unusual seeing him in purple coming off the heroics of a week ago. And let's not forget young Rodgers over there,
right
on the left. Any of you might have seen that opener against the Chicago Bears, the way he came up firing on that third and one to the end zone. I mean, he's a pretty good quarterback.
How excited do you think Aaron Rodgers and the Green Bay Packers team, after all the talk, not just this year, but even going back to last year, how excited are they to go on and take on Brett Favre?
So, folks, that's a reminder, Monday night.
That's Monday.
That's Monday night. You can catch that. Here's third down and three. First down. Ja'Cory Harris completes his first pass of the night, and it took four Oklahoma defenders to bring Johnson down.
Well, he gets back and he gets rid of the football. You can see how quickly Oklahoma's closing in on him. Dedrick Epps, the tight end, went to the flat and pulled the defenders with him, making it a pretty easy throw. But that's an important first down in this game, Brent, because after the way last week got started against Virginia Tech, they needed to establish something early here, and then they're going to tack on 15 yards on the back end after the conversion.
That's unnecessary roughness on him on top of it, as it took a gang to bring him down. Stoops has a Big 12 officiating crew here tonight. So Tavares Johnson lined up as an H-back, one of their fullbacks, and slipped out into his pass route and made that catch. And with the penalty now, the Canes are inside the Sooners 40-yard line. Ja'Cory off a play action going deep, intercepted, picked off at the 5-yard line by Franks. Franks out to the 17-yard line, and a pretty easy pick when you take a look at this throw.
There's a miscommunication here early. We saw some of this last week when they were on the road against Virginia Tech. Leonard Hankerson cut his route off early. He's in motion. He's going to be to the top of the screen. See how he breaks down there? And also you have the tight end trying to get out to the flat. I can see Ja'Cory, as soon as he threw it, looking over in the direction at both Hankerson on one side and LaRon Bird on the other. That's just a breakdown between the receivers and the quarterback, and a costly mistake here early.
Landry Jones, first possession for the Sooners. Redshirt freshman center. There's that little draw action handoff to Brown, and Brown crosses the 20-yard line. Sharpton makes the stop here. And so here is Landry Jones, the young man with his third start, 6 touchdowns a week ago, as Herbie told you, against Tulsa. Heavily recruited out of the state of New Mexico. He's going to throw for the first time, stepping left and wide open, complete, and into Hurricane territory. Ryan Broyles, that young man, number 85, has become Landry Jones' favorite target. And you're going to see a good arm here.
Brent, I love that you're already. Here's Landry Jones, a big question mark. How's he going to respond? What a great read. He goes backside to his favorite target, Ryan Broyles. And they're already at the line of scrimmage again. When it's Oklahoma, it's high octane. Get up to the line of scrimmage and snap the ball. No matter who the quarterback is, that's what you're going to get from Kevin Wilson's offense.
37 yards. DeMarco Murray checks in as the tailback. He's got great dash. Here he is trying to step to the outside, and the Canes were ready. Over on the sideline, meanwhile, last year's Heisman Trophy winner, Sam Bradford. And when you look at the Oklahoma schedule, next week at home against Baylor, you have to think there's a chance, because in 2 weeks, of course, it's the Red River Showdown in Dallas, Texas and Oklahoma. Second down and 9. Rolling to the right now, Landry's throwing on the move. Incomplete, threw it out of bounds. Receiver was down, appeared to be close to being out of bounds anyway. So now it'll be 3rd and 9.
You and I always kid about we have to adjust our own tempo when you call an Oklahoma game because of how quickly they get up to the line of scrimmage. Well, Miami's been prepping to face this up-tempo offense all week, but it's one thing to prep for it. How quickly do you adjust to it in the game? Brent, they moved DeMarco Murray right here. Somebody they want to try to get the football to, even as a wide receiver.
Far side, complete. Caleb got the first down with a terrific second effort. Brandon Caleb appeared to get the first down.
What an effort, Brent, as you said. And this is nice to see for Oklahoma. With Ryan Broyles carrying most of the load, with Jermaine Gresham down, they need Caleb to keep getting better and better. And last week, of course, 5 catches, 104 yards, and a couple scores against Tulsa.
Brown back in, and there was movement. The left guard for Oklahoma is pointing across the way, claiming the Canes were offside, and Adrian Hill is our referee here tonight.
Prior to the snap, offside defense, number 99 with contact. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
Marcus Forston was offsides as he jumped across.
But this tip, this tempo from Oklahoma will wear you down as a defense, and you lose a little bit of your edge mentally. You got to be very, very disciplined against this kind of offense.
Here's Brown. Brown battling toward that first down mark. Let's check in down below with Lisa.
Well, Brent, I just wanted to give you an update on Sam Bradford. I was talking to him during warm-ups. He said the shoulder felt good early in the week during practice, but felt sore later in the week. He said there was no swelling, but I asked him how much his NFL future figure into when he plays. He says, you know, it's a huge part. Quote, I don't want to rush it. I have a lot to think about.
So Brown rips down close to the 15. Yard line, and of course you have to know that one of the factors that goes into Bob Stoops and the entire coaching staff's decision on when to put Sam back in uniform on the field is exactly that, the young man's future. No matter how badly they may want to win this or the game against Texas, they will make a determination later. On the move, right end zone, that's a touchdown. OU Cameron Kinney, the junior, makes the grab of the end zone, and Sam Bradford's replacement has lit up the Hurricane defense on their first series.
Well, Landry Jones on the entire drive, Brent, 3 for 4 for 62 yards, in complete command of that up-tempo offense, and an outstanding throw to Kinney in the corner of the end zone. Wow, that was textbook and how to open a drive on the road.
Who would have seen Kinney coming as the first to score here tonight? Tacking on the extra point is Jimmy Stevens. Oklahoma strikes first. Well, the folks around the Oklahoma program have told me that Sam Bradford has stayed deeply involved, despite the fact that he has not played the last three games, that he's shown great leadership qualities. And there's the young man, 6 touchdowns a week ago, and now he's thrown for 1 already here. And this will be the second time that OU has kicked it away. Cooper coming up to the 10-yard line. Battling his way to the 29, and Herbie, let's go back to that score.
Well, this is poor coverage here. You're going to see, watch it, just at the line of scrimmage. You have a defensive back, Sam Shields, who tries to take a very physical approach in the way he went after Kinney, and he whiffed on it. And when he missed, it made it very easy for Kinney right there to use the technique to get around, and now it's just a simple throw. I'd say simple from up here. It's still a young freshman quarterback making a great throw. But at the line of scrimmage, Sam Shields guessed, tried to get physical and bump coverage, and Kinney went right around him with great technique. And how about the throw by Landry Jones?
It was an interception that set up that scoring drive for the Sooners. And the Canes were moving the ball pretty well. And on first down, Ja'Cory Harris puts it in Travis Benjamin's hands, the freshman from Belgrade, for the first time here tonight. And he's got some quicks.
So you lose 31-7 last week when everybody's telling you how wonderful you are. You come out here in this first drive, you throw an interception, you're down 7. It's a big drive for Ja'Cory Harris to be able to just get his team to settle down and get back to being who they are. And that's an offense that definitely has the ability to move the football here, but they've got to get their confidence back up. Quick throws.
Running behind the left side. And the Sooners gang up on James. Travis Lewis, just an outstanding linebacker, in on that stop.
Brent, we've seen some great defenses already, you and I, when we've been out. Alabama really sticks out in week 1, Virginia Tech in that same game. I think after we see 4 quarters of this defense, no matter what Miami's able to do, I think athletically and the experience, this defense doesn't take a back seat to anybody in the country.
Third and 1, big hole for James, crosses midfield, and he's out of bounds at the 44-yard line. That's Carter Marley, Sooner safeties there.
Nice little counter coming back here. Design drawback, and it created enough doubt in middle linebacker Ryan Reynolds' mind where he moved off to his left. And once he moved off to his left, it made it pretty easy for a nice block that time by Orlando Franklin to seal him to the inside. And Javaris James has enough power to be able to burst through that initial line of scrimmage there from Oklahoma's defensive front.
Offensive coordinator Mark Whipple calling the plays from the sideline. Kane's moving again. Harris on a deep drop going down the middle. Benjamin, and it is picked off again. This one intercepted by the other corner, Jackson. So Franks picks off the first one and Jackson the second one.
This is Brian Jackson sitting back as a safety, usually a corner. He's almost baiting and waiting for Corey Harris to throw that football. This defense moves too fast to float the ball up in the air like that.
OU's ball again. Timeout.
Saturday Night Football on ABC, presented by Southwest Airlines. Go to southwest.com. Grab your bag. It's on Chevy and Liberty Mutual Insurance. Responsibility. What's your policy?
Well, what began as an airboat ride attraction became the Everglades Alligator Farm, home to 2,000 gators of all sizes. Bob Freer gave our crew an airboat adventure through the park last night, and that is fabulous when you go through the Everglades, especially in the evening. Landry Jones back, second possession. Here's DeMarco Murray cutting, jumping, vaulting, smacked at the 14-yard line.
This is the freshman, Brent, that they're talking about, Ray Ray Armstrong, a true freshman. And they actually put him in the same sentence with the late, great Sean Taylor. He's wearing the same number.
Battling for the first down. Chains move again.
The entry to Randy Phillips, Ray Ray Armstrong will be in there, but don't have time to celebrate a big hit because Landry Jones and the Sooners are after you again.
Murray.
Talked about Miami needing a bounce back game after the way they played against Virginia Tech, Brent. I think this is Oklahoma, a team that's on a bit of a mission themselves after the way they opened up the season against BYU.
Second and six. Henry Jones is taken down by Robinson. Marcus Robinson.
Marcus Robinson just using speed to get right around Jarvis Jones, and nothing fancy outside of being healthy and being able to use that speed on the edge there. That's one thing that's hurt Miami is their defensive linemen have been fighting through a lot of injuries. That's great speed off the edge there.
Third down and 12. Wide open receiver, couldn't hit him because he was under pressure. Caleb had broken free, but there was heat on Landry Jones that time, or they would have picked up an easy first down plus. Look at this.
Sam Shields again, Brent. There's confusion on the back end behind him, not to mention he tried again to jam, and he whipped on it. And if Landry Jones had just a little bit more time, that's a big touchdown.
Pressure from Regas. Almost blocked. Fair catch is signaled. And there is a penalty flag thrown back where the punter was. On the 6-yard line, Tress Way. First punt of the night. And that's a 5-yard, I believe I read his lips.
Running into the kicker, defense.
It's a matter of whether it was going to be roughing or running into him.
that was running into, and it was fourth and 12.
Yeah, exactly.
So it'll be Hurricanes football when you come back. Down by seven, but that was a very good defensive series by the Canes.
You're watching ESPN on ABC, home of the 2010 Rose Bowl game and the City BCS National Championship game.
Well, Mark Whipple was in the NFL last year, and now he is the offensive coordinator of the Miami Hurricanes. And he and his quarterback have not been on the same page so far, Herbie.
No, and I think right now Ja'Cory Harris is kind of against the ropes here. He needs to stop floating the ball so high and put the ball a little bit more on a lower angle.
Cooper, his first handoff. And Lewis again making the stop.
They've got to make quick decisions, running the football, maybe some misdirection, some counters, something to take an aggressive approach against a defense that is just flying downhill. Play action also. And instead of going downfield, try to find the tight ends and receivers underneath against those linebackers.
Second and five. Whipple telling us yesterday that he had to be able to run the football, and certainly he has tried here tonight, gaining 50 yards on the ground so far. And there is that youngster Lewis again.
Brent, watch the linebackers. Watch how fast they just close down. I mean, the offensive linemen don't even have time to adjust, because by the time they come out of their stance, the linebackers are already by them and they're in the backfield. You've got to make a defense pay for that by trying to go play action to a quick throw to the tight end right over the middle where they were.
Need 5 yards. And try to throw for it. Drop in underneath this time for the first down. So there he is going to the short passing game. And that's LaRon Bird, the sophomore wide receiver.
That's what I think it's going to take to be able to try to find some openings in this zone defense. Just try to get in front of them and try to get the ball to a great athlete in open space and hope that he can make a play. And that time, that's exactly what LaRon Bird was able to do.
Reminds me of Michael Irvin crossing the field in days of old.
That's right.
The Sooners making a grab.
Little dance in the end zone.
First down and 10. And big shift by the offense. And a pitch to Cooper. Cooper crosses the 40-yard line before Carter makes a stop. So again, this is the third time tonight that the Canes, Herbie, have been able to move the ball at the start of a series, but the two interceptions have disrupted the flow. But by keeping it short, and I'm impressed so far by their ability to run the ball here tonight.
Yeah, and when they can get the football to the outside, away from that speed of those linebackers that time, you just saw Cooper outrun number 28, Travis Lewis, got to the corner and allowed him to pick up a pretty good yardage there on first and 10.
And that 28 is Collier, a wide receiver who just checked in. There it is again on a crossing route, and that is Hankerson from St. Thomas Aquinas up the road in Fort Lauderdale. What a game they had last night against South Carolina's Burns High School. Folks, there are 19 FBS senior prospects on Fort Lauderdale's St. Thomas Aquinas. That's right, 19, and how many are on Burns? So there were, well, about 30 prospects. Urban Meyer of Florida was on the side. So was just Joe Castiglione, the athletic director at Oklahoma, but he wasn't scouting. That's where he went to high school. Third down and one. Play fake on third and one, sets the screen, and they pick up the first down. Cooper. So a well-called play by Whipple, expecting the rush as they drop back that time. They let that great defensive front penetrate, and now Whipple and Ja'Cory are on the same page, moving the ball underneath, as Herbie suggested they had to do.
You know, and the other thing, Brent, is I'm impressed with the composure of young Ja'Cory Harris. We have such high expectations for this young man. He's a young guy. He's a true sophomore. He's making his sixth career start. Imagine starting a game like this on national TV with a couple interceptions. Keep your composure and lead this team.
James is back with the running back. Tried to step through the hole and made the most. west of it for a couple of yards. And let's check in with Matt Weiner in Times Square for an update. What a Saturday afternoon, Matt.
Absolutely. This is a Taco Bell update from Berkeley tonight. Number 7 USC in town. They turned a Taylor Mays interception into points already. Joe McKnight bounces that outside into the blue, 38 yards. It's a 10-0 lead there. Now Auburn leads Tennessee on ESPN 6-0.
Gene Chizik at Auburn. Remember how he was criticized by a lot of fans for taking the job? He never forgotten how to coach defense. For those of you who didn't like that hire, trust me on that. There's Shakur in trouble. And he will take that sack at the 39-yard line rather than trying to do something foolish. And Jeremy Beal comes in and tackles the game quarterback.
Beal comes in, but you see right there, Brian Jackson, a corner blitz near side coming from Ja'Cory Harris's right. And that's something that gave Miami some problems last week, not recognizing blitz and pressure. Brent Venables is one of the best. I'm sure he used that as a blueprint last week to figure out not only dominating with the front four, but occasionally getting creative with bringing some pressures. That time it worked to perfection.
Third and 13, and that front can tee off this time. Linebacker blitz. They tried to screen, and it is deflected by Jeremy Beal again.
Beal brought the pressure, and there were two linebackers waiting on the outside. You see two of them right there, Ryan Reynolds and Travis Lewis, just waiting for James in case he had a chance to catch that football. Again, very, very well defended by this Oklahoma defense.
So here comes the Canes punter. He also kicks extra points and field goals. That is Matt Washer in the corner. Franks waits back at the Sooners 10-yard line. Defended inside the 5-yard line. A beautiful punt by Matt Washer of Jupiter, Florida. Well, there's a new place for you to go to get the latest on the teams you care about. Fans in Boston, Chicago, and Dallas, log on to your favorite city there and get all the updates on the local teams. ESPNChicago.com, Boston.com, Dallas.com. I think I heard that New York is in the works. And, of course, they'll be down here in South Florida. So, quickly, the Sooners will start 99 yards away. Brown breaks a tackle. 20-yard line in a foot race. On first down, Telemac finally gets the running back down. But what a way to bail yourself out of a field position jam, a 48-yard run.
What a block right there by the fullback, and then just a missed tackle by the safety. And there's nobody left but Matt Clapp, the fullback, leading the way through that hole, open things up for Chris Brown.
Landry Jones straight back, going deep into double coverage. Caleb was covered that time, and there's a penalty flag. However, there was contact. Caleb was trying to break free, and there was contact.
Marcus Van Dyke, as Brandon Caleb is going out for his route.
Pass interference, defense, number 8, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Without a doubt, he was pulling and trying to get in position. And while he's getting in position, his right arm is grabbing on to Brandon Caleb. And then he gets his left arm in there. And of course, that is pass interference. And 1 second, you're pinned inside your own 1-yard line. And a couple plays later, you're at the Miami 36.
Play fake again. Had to drop it off quickly to Murray, who was working that far sideline because of the pressure that time from Riga. focus.
Let's not forget that so much attention is being put on Landry Jones, but Bob Stoops and Kevin Wilson, the offensive coordinator, said this week, we have confidence in Landry and what he can do. We're anxious to see how the offensive line will play, the tight ends, the young receivers. How will the players around him play to give him a chance to execute?
Second and 10, and it's Murray to the 33-yard line.
People that are not
final familiar. Minute and fear the stash, folks, because that's Landry Jones who has.
Oh boy!
There we go. It's not easy drinking that land shark when you got a stash like that.
First quarter, you got the. It's
not a bad lager. Third down and 8. From the gun, sets the screen, short of the first down, Caleb.
Sean Spence all over that football play and almost blew it up before Caleb was able to fight through there and pick up a few yards.
Field goal time. Stoops was thinking about it on 4th and 2, but instead he'll use Stevens with seconds running down here in the first quarter. They'll kick it the other way. So they'll turn them around. If you're Oklahoma, you're very pleased with the start. If you're Miami, you've got to think it could have been a lot worse. And they'll gladly settle for a field goal on this drive. And this presentation of Saturday Night Football presented by Southwest Airlines returns after this message and a word from our ABC stations. Jimmy Stevens set to kick the field goal with Carter Whitson to hold here. And Kirby and I discussed the possibility of a fake, but after a timeout, you would think the Canes would be watching. No, they're going to go to it anyway. They were ready. They stopped it. They stopped it at 4th and 2. It would be just like Bob Stoops to go for it here. And they did. Telemach was ready. The problem with calling that fake after a timeout is you give the defense a lot of time to run down the options.
Well, that's the last thing Randy Shannon, his coaches, told them. They know Bob Stoops. You and I were talking about it at the break. It's going to be obviously very close. But this is Bob Stoops. He's on the road. He's got a lead. His defense is playing well. He coaches to win. Whether this works out or not, he always is aggressive with his decision making. Got a pretty favorable spot here. This
I thought so too.
Pretty close.
Wow. How close is that for a first down? Let's go to Matt Weiner in New York. Matt.
All right, Brent, let's get a check of our primetime pulse on ESPN. That potent Auburn offense has only been able to put up 6 points so far. Nothing for Tennessee. Meanwhile, Texas A&M and Arkansas, Southwest Conference rivalry renewing on ESPN2 from Cowboys Stadium. Jevin Snead already has a pair of touchdown passes on ESPN. ESPNU is Ole Miss leads Vanderbilt.
So Brown will be the running back. And the Sooners, after the fake field goal, pick up the two. The ball at the 26-yard line. Landry Jones, there is a penalty flag. You saw movement in the lines at the line of scrimmage.
Offside.
Second offside against that Kane defensive line. Regas.
Still first half.
Forced and guilty that time.
Talk about it. Couple plays that can be demoralizing for Miami. They really need to step up here, and somebody needs to show some leadership to try to slow down Oklahoma, because Oklahoma is now really going to come after him here with a new set of downs.
The draw motion with Brown. Penalty flag. Thrown by the umpire. Our umpire tonight is Tom Quick.
I think they got Brian Simmons, left guard there.
Holding offense. Number 74, 10-yard penalty.
this offensive line, as we talked earlier, Brent, still, you know, they're still trying to find their own rhythm and a little bit of continuity issues. You have Trent Williams, the left tackle, who was all conference last year on that big, strong offensive line, but the only one that returned with Jermaine Grisham out, the best tight end in the country. This line is still gelling.
First and 15, nothing doing that time. Well, you mentioned Grisham, and probably not enough has been made about the fact that Stoops has had to carry on without the best tight end in all of football. There you see the young man and rehabbing that knee injury. And I think as much as anything else, that really hurt them against BYU. When you go back and study that game a little bit, even with Landry quarterbacking in the second half, he did not have that target in the middle of the field. The tight end now actually was playing center that day, and here Landry whips one to the outside to Kenny, and there's another penalty flag down.
I think they're going to get a face mask on Sam Shields, who's had a rough go of it so far in this game.
Personal foul, face mask, defense, number 9. Half the distance to the goal from the end of the run, automatic first down.
And Shields a couple times isolated one-on-one has given up some big plays through the air by trying to get physical and jam. This time gets beat on the play. It would have set up a big third down if he just makes the tackle there.
Ball is spotted at the 11 for the Sooners, who lead it by 7.
Doing everything they can when the opportunity presents itself to rotate bodies in, just trying to stay fresh against this tempo. That's the thing that happens to you when you face Oklahoma, is you get tired, especially up front on the defensive line.
Comes the blitz. Landry stands tall, incomplete. A little bit high for Kenny.
Kenny broke free again from Sam Shields. I think what's happened is the young quarterback, Landry Jones, is either getting told to attack 9 in orange, or he's starting to feel that, because Sam Shields, as good as he's been for Miami this year, tonight he's been giving up some openings to Kenny and the rest of the Oklahoma receivers.
4 rush this time. Fire in underneath, short of the first down. This time, Stoops probably won't fake it. Remember that drive began at the 1, and there was that 48-yard run by Chris Brown late in the first quarter. Fake field goal, then kept the drive alive, and Stevens trots back out.
Anytime you get pinned inside your 1-yard line, and you're able to try to come away with an opportunity to get points, that's always a win.
21-yarder. And Oklahoma builds a 10-point lead. Crowd of about 60,000 tonight here in Miami.
Buffalo Wild Wings presents the top 30 plays of the last 30 years. Number 24, punting late in a tied game versus Clemson. Florida State instead called Punt-Rooski. The ball was snapped to upback Dean Williams, who then slipped it between the legs of Leroy Butler. Butler rushed 78 yards to set up the game-winning field goal for the Seminoles. And the Punt-Rooski was born. Follow the top 30 countdown all season long. Brought to you by Buffalo Wild Wings.
Leroy Butler played the defensive backfield a dozen years for the Green Bay Packers. He'd never had a rushing attempt in the NFL. I can still see that play in my sleep.
You know what the new countdown we got to do is, how many of the top 30 did Brent Musburger call? we could do our own. We'll just keep track throughout the rest of the year.
That gummit, that one really fooled me. Yeah. Here's the kickoff, and the Canes will try it again. Coming out for the 1-yard line is Cooper. Penalty flag. Another penalty flag. There's enough yellow to bring this back and then some.
Illegal bunt during the return, number 36. 10-yard penalty, first out.
Randy a little frustrated over there on the sideline. The Sooners have opened up a 10-point lead here with 11:25 to go in the second quarter.
Well, there are a couple penalties here. There's the first one right there. Robinson, a linebacker on special teams, but there was another one about 10 yards downfield. So after looking like they may have a nice return, now they're inside their own 10-yard line. And this stadium is kind of in shock as they sit here and wait for something to get excited about with Ja'Cory Harris.
Ball is spotted inside the 10. James, the running back, slips a couple of tackles. Battles his way to the 15-yard line. And, you know, after making that big statement with a victory at Dover, defending champion Jimmy Johnson keeps his sights set on current points leader and ageless wonder Mark Martin. The chase for the NASCAR Sprint Cup continues in Kansas. Coverage begins Sunday at 1 Eastern on ABC. So Johnson in hot pursuit, trailing the ageless one by only 10 points. Second down now for the Canes. Ja'Cory back in the gun. Fires for the first down and a wide open Johnson. And there is his favorite target from Northwestern High School. There are seven players on this roster who were recruited by Randy Shannon from the same high school here in Miami. And Kirk, as you know, Northwestern is a powerhouse down here.
You talked about St. Thomas Aquinas and their game last night, but Northwestern High School, one of the best not only in South Florida but could compete with anybody nationally on an annual basis. 7-1 class goes to Miami. It's a pretty good high school football team.
Indeed. Well, he's found a soft corner over there and he goes right back to Johnson.
There's the relationship you've talked about, Brent, playing in high school together, knowing each other very well. Anticipation. He throws his football before Johnson's even out of his break. The soft cushion makes it a little easier. But right there, as soon as he turned, the football is right on the money. And all of a sudden, if you're Oklahoma, you got to think, you know what, let's maybe take away that soft cushion. It's making it too easy for Harris, especially towards that boundary.
Johnson looks like he's styling a little bit like a Kane receiver, too. Come back with James, big hole in the middle, and a foot race across midfield. Carter with the angle, able to get him out of bounds, but now the crowd has something to be excited about. The Canes are stocking their first score of the night here.
What a great double team in the middle, right at the middle. The center, number 70, Trump, the right guard, Gunn. They did a good job against that athletic Oklahoma defensive line and just pushing them. And then the vision from Javaris James to cut this back right to where the opening was, and then it became a foot race.
That's a 50-yard gain by James. Cooper will give James a break. He checks in as the running back. Collier lines up as the offset fullback. Ja'Cory has it deflected on the ground, dives back for the loose football, was knocked out of his hand. Wind it for second down.
Well, I mean, they caught a break. The pressure, the zone pressure. They brought Keenan Clayton. You'll see him come from the bottom. They also brought Ryan Reynolds, and they dropped a couple defensive linemen. It confused Miami up front, able to get to Ja'Cory Harris, and at that point, it's a dogpile trying to come up with that football.
Jason Fox pouncing on it there with Ja'Cory right there with him.
Last guy in for Miami somehow comes up with a football.
Get Cooper out of the backfield. Fires. And the catch by the tight end, Jimmy Graham. And what Giannis story. The basketball player who dropped two big ones on one drive in the second half when it appeared as though the Canes might be coming back. Jacory Harris goes to him for the score. Miami with 6 points, and you got to be so happy for that young man right there. Here's Boucher. Game on. There's a penalty flag down at the 12-yard line. There is that touchdown strike to Graham right down the middle. The officials are talking about the flag that was thrown on the extra point. So the Canes make it a 3-point game. Bouncing back with a little style.
Saturday Night Football on ABC. Presented by Southwest Airlines. Go to southwest.com. Grab your bag. It's on. More. We speak car. We speak innovation. Introducing the all-new Taurus. Drive one. And Aflac. We've got you under our wing.
Well, there's where the old Orange Bowl stood. All those great years and great games. Now an overpass being built down there. Many, many memories for a lot of folks here in South Florida and around the country. From Doug Flutie to Kellen Winslow. Joe Namath. It could go on and on. But here they are in their new digs. Landshark Stadium, where the Dolphins play their home games. They'll play Buffalo tomorrow. Uribe will kick it off for the first time in this game for the Canes. They have pulled to within three. From the end zone is Franks. Surrounded. Can't get the edge. Back to the score.
Well, this is Mark Whipple's NFL background. Get inside the red zone. Benjamin's going to come here and come under. Graham's allowed to get in here and finds a seam. Watch this unfold and watch Benjamin draw a couple defenders with him this way. When he does that, two defenders from Oklahoma go there and it opens up, makes it a very easy read and a good throw by Jacory Harris for the touchdown. But that's Mark Whipple. In the NFL, great way to attack a defense. Jacory Harris gets hit again, but this time has just enough time to make the throw.
Meanwhile, the kickoff has been called back. Offside on the kickoff, which of course is an inexcusable mistake on the part of your kicking team in that situation. In our Pacific Life game summary, as we check in on how our two quarterbacks are doing here tonight. Landry Jones replacing the injured Sam Bradford has thrown for a touchdown, but now Jacory Harris has overcome those two interceptions earlier in this game, and he has his first score of the night.
If what doesn't show up in the stats is that Landry Jones comes in with all the pressure and trying to replace Sam Bradford. First drive did a nice job of leading the Sooners down to a touchdown. And then what Jacory Harris did after throwing the two picks, offense was just struggling along to come right back and be able to put Miami in this game to get a little bit of life, this football team, and into this stadium.
Sooners figured to get a return this time. From the 13-yard line is Franks. What a difference that 5-yard penalty made. Out to the 36, and we check in with Matt Weiner.
All right, Brent, here's what's happening on SportsCenter right now. Michael Kadire hit the go-ahead home run as the Twins beat the Royals today. That means their AL Central battle with the Tigers will go to tomorrow's final day of the regular season. Meanwhile, Damian Williams has a 66-yard punt return for USC. The number 7 Trojans lead at Cal already 17-0.
Here, Matt, it is 10-7. Oklahoma leading Miami. The Sooners with the ball. Landry Jones with the handoff to Murray. Murray slips the first tackle. And he's to the 37-yard line.
Big part of tonight's Oklahoma offensive scheme was seeing how number 12 Landry Jones and this offensive line would respond to this speed.
Murray again. This will put them in a passing situation for Kevin Wilson, who's calling the plays upstairs on this third down. He was once the offensive coordinator up at Northwestern.
Big thing he wanted to reiterate to his team this week is, with or without Sam, we're going to be aggressive.
Wanted to set the screen short of the first down. Crowd very much alive as the Canes battle back here in the first half.
The first time tonight that you just feel that this defense is playing with a little bit of emotion, and that the Oklahoma's offense is a bit uneasy with the pressure and with the intensity that they faced that time from Miami's defense.
Wade punting again. The youngster Benjamin standing back at the Canes 20. Beautiful punt. Can he stop it? Goes into the end zone. Comes out on the 20-yard line. So Randy Shannon's Canes will have the ball back on the 20-yard line, trailing Oklahoma by 3 here in the first half.
Let's put a few thousand kilowatts in a vise. Squeeze some savings back into our budget, into our attics and walls. Let's locate the original energy source called you and turn that machine up full blast. More saving, more doing. That's the power of the Home Depot. Come get 50% more savings on insulation with a new lower price of just $9.37 per roll.
Retirement. It may be a long way off, or another adventure waiting just ahead. Pacific Life can help provide a dependable income you can enjoy for the rest of your life. Because retirement could be a very long ride. Ask your financial professional about Pacific Life. Pacific Life, the power to help you succeed.
Scientific tests prove when you drink Dr. Pepper slow, 23 flavors taste even better. For me, slow always produces a hit. Step aside for a minute. Check this out. Slower is better. Trust me. Doctor.
Hey, if you're thinking of getting a truck, do your buddies a favor and try out the back seat where they gotta sit. Yeah, it's bad. It's as roomy as the glove box and as comfortable as the tailgate. Until now, that is. This is the Ford F-150 Super Crew. It's got 6 more inches of room, and it's the only truck with a completely flat floor. So it's easier to load cargo and more comfortable. Shotgun? You don't need no stinking shotgun. It's not just a pickup truck. It's a Ford F-150.
Kelsey Grammer is Hank. All new Wednesday, 8, 7 Central on ABC.
MetLife is providing these dramatic views of Landshark Stadium. MetLife provides coverage of major sporting events while also providing you with guarantees for the ifs in life. Oklahoma's finding it's no guarantee even when you open up a 10-point lead. The Canes are back in the thick of this, coming out now to the 20-yard line, and Cooper will be the tailback to open this series. And around Benjamin. A lot of movement for only a yard. Lewis makes the stop. Well, time for tonight's Aflac trivia question.
Here we go.
Who is the only person to be head coach at both Oklahoma and Miami?
Yeah, I got that one.
Absolutely.
Yeah, that's a layup. What are you doing? You feeling sorry for me?
Well, you know.
What is this?
Stay tuned. I got a bonus one for you.
Still coaching that.
Hey, Florida Atlantic. Yeah. You're playing Wyoming.
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness. What a hit.
That helps.
Was it second down and nine.
Play. Delay, delay.
Over the middle.
There you go.
Working that underneath. That's Collier with his first reception of the night. Lisa, what do you got for us?
Hey, Brent, something to keep an eye on with the Miami offensive line. Of course, they were happy with that effort on the last touchdown drive, but they were definitely out of gas when they came over to the sideline. Several players got oxygen from the tanks that are down here over there on the Miami sidelines.
Yep, that'll happen blocking these big rascals.
Yeah. We're only in the first half.
Can't blame them. A.J. Trump bending over the ball from the gun. Bottle picks it up. Incomplete, but short of the first down. Franks making a nice play on the receiver bird.
Another blitz from Oklahoma. They get you to third down. They're going to create some confusion. Again, Lewis comes under the inside, makes the guard come down, and makes it very easy for Ryan Reynolds to lock in and put the pressure again on Jacory Harris. I don't think he's thrown very many passes tonight without feeling the pressure, even after he throws the ball.
There's Franks back there, set to return. Fair catch is signaled for inside the 20 at around the 17-yard line. Butcher's big leg. The Ibis says, come on, man.
This is weak, man.
We welcome you back. Let's cue up Aflac. Herbie, take us to the answer.
That would be Howard Schellenberg.
Absolutely.
He's coaching at Florida Atlantic.
One of Don Shula's assistant coaches. They stayed unbeaten. Then he became the Miami head coach, won a national championship with Bernie Kosar as his quarterback. Moved to Oklahoma, but only for 1 year before he packed up, moved to Louisville. Now he's got the program started with Florida Atlantic. Here comes the end around. Madu bringing him off the slot, the converted running back. For a first down, the first time he has touched the ball here tonight.
Madu in this football game because Ryan Broyles went into the locker room. And hopefully he'll have a chance to come back in this game. But all of a sudden, Moses Madu, who's known to be a running back in this offense, has moved to the outside because the need for more playmakers on the outside. Maybe get more opportunities tonight to make some plays.
There to Madu on the outside, read beautifully by McCarthy.
Think about what this Oklahoma team lost. You lose four of your offensive linemen. The best tight end gets hurt this year. The Heisman Trophy quarterback's out. Your top two receivers from last year, no problem. They lost everything except for a couple running backs and a left tackle.
There's Gresham. Sam alongside. Josh Heupel. He wanted. BCS championship right here against Florida State one night. Madu again on the end around. And that was read beautifully by Ray Ray Armstrong, the freshman.
There he is, the true freshman, future superstar. Maybe he's going to be a star right now. At times showing discipline to stay at home.
Meanwhile, Marcus Robinson down for the Canes.
Might have been on a block. Anytime there's a reverse, you always worry about blocks that it go low right there. Jarvis Jones on the reverse came to the obviously submarined him. He's coming off the field, which is always good news. But, you know, Ray Armstrong staying at home, and Moses Madu now has had three opportunities here to make a play here for Oklahoma.
Herbie, coming up on the Bud Light Halftime Report, John and Jesse will have all the day's big highlights. Washington took Notre Dame to overtime before the Irish prevailed in the first overtime. If you haven't seen the clips, it's worth sticking around for. A very dramatic game in South Bend. Bad, nasty weather. Jake Locker and the Huskies building on a season to be proud of. as that draw from the shotgun, and Murray picks it up just short of midfield. Well called by Kevin Wilson.
You look around at these wide receivers and you wonder who's capable of making a play for Landry Jones, and Kevin Wilson goes the safe route. It's set up perfectly, great blocking up front, and there's the acceleration you like to see from DeMarco Murray.
Now they come to the tight end, and that is Brody Eldridge with his first reception of the night. He is a very, very good blocker. Started the season against BYU as the Oklahoma center. And then with Gresham out because of the injury, they moved Eldridge back out to tight end. Now there is Gresham, who put all kinds of pressure on defenses a year ago. It was one of the most difficult matchups, as another Kane is down. That's Joseph. But Gresham, one of the most difficult matchups in all of college football. And if the young man plays anywhere like what we saw last year, Herbie, he'll be a Sunday star for a long time. When you look around Sunday football, he's the one weapon that you want right now is a tight end with size who can get down the middle of the field. There's some of those big rascals right now getting a little rest, getting ready for tomorrow.
Well, he can block as well as any tight end, but as you said, he can catch the underneath route, and he can get downfield and put pressure on those safeties down the middle of the field.
Well, the new season of ABC's Desperate Housewives just getting started. An attack on Susan's daughter will have everyone wondering, how well do we really know our neighbors? Naughty affairs, crazy stalkers, and misbehaving young nieces spice up life on Wisteria Lane. Desperate Housewives airs Sunday at 9, 8 Central. What a neighborhood.
Spice up life.
Wow.
Oh, mercy.
My neighborhood wasn't like that growing up. What about you?
No. I hope not. It's crazy.
Yeah, Joseph.
Some of these injuries starting to mount for both these teams. I mean, the Ryan Broyles injury for Oklahoma is very, very significant, because coming into tonight's game, he had 22 receptions. The closest to him was Brandon Caleb, who had 10. He's their go-to guy.
Second down and one, inside of 2 minutes left here for OU. They still got their timeouts, all three of them remaining. Picked up the first down. They'll spot the ball, and the chains will move. Clock stops momentarily. 1:44 to go here. Big for both these teams right now at the end of the first half.
Minute 44 with three timeouts, and this kind of offense, time at this point is not an issue for Landry Jones. Plenty of time to work with.
Stepping out to the left and firing complete. Getting a first down is Tunnell.
Once he got to the outside and broke contain, he had plenty of time to make a decision on where he wanted to go with the football. Adron Tunnell that time fighting for yards.
Off a play fake. Jones, and you can see for the mark, they did not give him that first down spot. There is a penalty flag thrown.
Holding offense number 34. 10-yard penalty.
1 minute left for Stoops and the Sooners, leading by three.
It caught Matt Clapp, who's had a pretty good game tonight blocking, but he is locked on right there with Alan Bailey, and referee is staring it down and actually made the call himself.
Play
took some time to develop, and with the speed up front from Miami, they're getting off their blocks much quicker as this game progresses. And again, they're trying to, as I said, trying to rotate those bodies best they can, and Regis came right down in a hurry and took Murray out of the picture.
Final 30 seconds. Third and 13 here at the end of the first half. They will not get the first down. Caleb is surrounded.
Miami that time just sat back, keeping the play in front of them. Great job by Miami's defense on this drive to force either the punt.
Well, they take one of the timeouts. 15 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. Oklahoma scoring the first 10 points of the game. Then Miami got on the board. And now we close out the first half. If you just joined us, Landry Jones still quarterbacking in place of the injured Sam Bradford. And in case you're wondering about Landry Jones, yes, he was named after the former legendary Dallas Cowboy head coach Tom Landry. His mom and dad were huge Dallas Cowboy fans, and thus Landry Jones. Landry back, fourth and eight, has plenty of time, can't find anybody open, and he's in a foot race, shakes free, still battling to throw it out of bounds with 3 seconds remaining.
Best thing he did there on fourth down is chew up 11 seconds of the clock and then finally just throw it away, giving Miami maybe just enough time for just a one play. This is a big stop for Miami because Miami won the toss and elected to take the football, which means Oklahoma will get the ball to start the second half. So be able to stop Oklahoma here, keep it at a three-point game, very, very big for their psyche as they head in at halftime.
Low scoring?
Very low scoring.
What we thought it might be.
Yes. Defensive flying around.
So that would be the score at halftime. Oklahoma 10, Miami 7. Let's go to Lisa with Coach Randy Shannon.
Thanks, Brent. Coach, Jacory Harris had two picks in your first two possessions. What was giving him problems early on?
Well, he just took some shots. You know, he's trying to make a big play instead of reading the coverages. But I think he settled down. We got our run game going. You know, the guys are really banging up front with the offensive line. So we're keeping our running game going, and they'll get Jacory a better shot to get some opportunities.
And what changed for him on that touchdown drive?
Well, basically, settled down. Like I said, if we get our run game going, we're going to be okay. And that'll settle him down.
All right, thanks, Coach.
Trailing only by three. And right now, let's send it to the Times Square studio to John Saunders and Jesse Palmer for the Bud Light Halftime Report. Welcome you back to Saturday Night Football on ABC, presented by Southwest Airlines. Good one from South Florida. 3-point lead, Oklahoma over Miami. Herbie, we're going to take a look at our Southwest Airlines playbook. Rough start for the Hurricanes' young quarterback, Jacory Harris.
Yeah, Jacory Harris, after playing the way he did last week and the Canes did last week, their first two possessions, he tried to get the ball thrown downfield and tried to make big plays, and he had two costly interceptions, one of them leading to an Oklahoma touchdown. But he stepped back in there and made a great throw to Graham for a touchdown to put Miami in a position now where they have a shot here in the second half to win this football game.
Remember, Miami won the toss and they elected to receive. So the Sooners will have the first possession of the second half. Uribe with the ball on the tee for the Hurricanes to kick it off here. Madu and Franks back, and Coach Randy Shannon. It's DeMarco Murray. Madu handled the ball three consecutive times in the first half, seeing his first action of the night. That came late in the second quarter. Here comes
do from the goal line. Oh, brought down at the 15-yard line as the Kings open up strong here in the second half after the intermission. You know, things like that can give you a lift now.
Oh, there's no doubt. Watching the team's energy as they came out of the second half, Miami's feeling really good about themselves. And I want to see if Oklahoma, we'll have to check with Lisa on Ryan Broyles to find out if he's going to come back in the second half. But they need playmakers around Landry Jones right now to step up, mainly Chris Brown and DeMarco Murray, two proven commodities for this Oklahoma offense.
I do not see 85 in this offensive set to open up the second half, and DeMarco Murray will get the first carry. And let us check in down below with Lisa.
Well, Brennan, injury update on Ryan Broyles. Bob Stoops told me that it was a shoulder injury. He wouldn't tell me which shoulder, but we saw Ryan Broyles come out of the locker room a short while ago with his left arm in a sling. He spent about a half an hour in the x-ray room, but again, Stoops would not tell me the extent of the shoulder injury.
Fumble! Kings go for the loose ball. They've recovered it and around the Sooners' 10-yard line. Brandon Harris popping off of that pile.
How about Brandon Harris coming off the edge here to speed, and it's not picked up by Oklahoma. The tight end there, Eldridge, needs to be able to recognize that. Also, it could be a matter of shifting the offensive line to the right. That's exactly what Miami needed to see here. Aggressive defense pays off. The Canes get the football.
Remember the tackle on the kickoff. It lit the fuse here in South Florida. On first down, Ja'Cory Harris stands tall. End zone touchdown. The scoring strike to Epps. And just like that, Miami takes its first lead of the night. Tacks on the extra point. The hurricane alert is up now for the Sooners. His second touchdown pass of the night. He is a cool cat. Pull up a chair, folks. 10 o'clock in the east, 8 o'clock out Montana way, 7 o'clock in Oregon. We got a good one here in South Florida. 14-10, the Canes. Remember that last kickoff. Remember what started this fire. Kick coverage by a youngster out of New Jersey, number 38, Corey Nelms. Downfield to make the tackle. There's Madu back to the 14-yard line. Smacked at the 34-yard line, and it's tight ends, tight ends, tight ends, Herbie.
I love to see this call. Here's Keenan Clayton on the outside, who's actually going to be manned up with Epps right here, who's going to work to the middle of the field. The coverage isn't bad. This is a big-time throw right here by Ja'Cory Harris. And how about the concentration by Epps at 6'4 to go up into the air and take it away from a would-be defender?
The second scoring strike of the night to a tight end. Graham was first and Epps is second. So Whipple from the National Football League has found a matchup advantage against linebackers. Now Landry Jones firing over the middle for an incompletion.
Let's keep everything in perspective here, Brent. Landry Jones has stepped in for Sam Bradford tonight, doing a pretty good job. Offensive line is held up for the most part. The concern is on the outside. Breaking in new receivers, trying to find the rhythm, trying to find a receiver who can help him here in the second half with Broyles out for the game.
Gresham out for the season. A shorthanded OU offense. Brown, nothing doing. Read perfectly by Mankur. Eric Mankur makes the stop, the senior from Miami.
Really, really good defense right now by Miami. They're playing with discipline. That time he actually had to fight off a hold by Eldridge and still was able to get to the outside to keep contained.
And suddenly it's third and 11 for the Sooners. Four-man rush. Offensive line does a good job. Had time. Threw for the first down. Got it over to the far side to Kinney. He caught the touchdown pass in the first half.
I'll tell you what, huge play by Landry Jones. Considering where we are in this game, the field beginning to tilt, favoring Miami, a big third and long, and he's going to go from the hash all the way to the sideline.
Sort of surprised John Lovett didn't whistle up any pressure that time as Murray was the ball carrier.
The torch has been handed to DeMarco Murray, Chris Brown, Moses Badu, some of the more proven commodities, but give a Cameron Kenny a lot of credit so far tonight of being a newcomer to step up.
Canes obviously feel they can get there with their rush. The end breaks free, and there's a penalty flag thrown by the referee. So breaking through was Alan Bailey, number 57, and there's going to be a holding call here.
Jarvis Jones, it's second time that's happened to him, number 76 in right tackle, the LSU transfer.
Holding offense, number 76. That penalty is declined. Third down.
There's some unpleasant memories in this stadium for Stoops and Oklahoma. An 8-yard loss on the sack as the penalty was declined. Third and 13. Again, a four-man rush. Incomplete. Madu, the intended target. And a penalty flag comes late.
Sean Spence here looks
pass
like Brent.
Defense, number 31, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
The only way Oklahoma converts this third down is if they catch a break here because the pressure is closing in on Landry Jones. It's only a matter when the ball's in the air. I mean, it was a little bit of contact there, but I don't know if it's enough for pass interference.
I think it was, young man, and right arm was saying, come waltz with me, Matilda. You've got to call that one.
Matilda.
First down and 10. Out of the pistol, the handoff to Murray. To the Canes, 40-yard line.
Kevin Wilson telling us this week that with DeMarco Murray getting healthy, it's important to try to get him 15 to 20 touches in a big-time game like this. He's got to welcome this opportunity.
Niddle, close to a first down. Telemac, one of the safeties. Remember, the safety, Randy Phillips, is out with an injury tonight. We've seen number 26, the freshman, Ray Armstrong, back there, and Jared Campbell. So they're without the veteran Phillips. Short-handed back there. Third down and 1. Jones keeps it himself right straight ahead to move the chains.
Depending on what happens with this drive, of course, we're going to look at that third down pass interference call. Could be a big turning point, not only for this drive, if Oklahoma's able to get points, but maybe in this ball game here in the second half with Miami starting to take control of this game. The Sooners catch a break.
Comes a blitz. Jones in a foot race to the sideline. Has to throw it away, and it, Marcus Robinson, number 56, in hot pursuit.
The speed of this Miami defensive front. We've talked so much tonight about Oklahoma's defensive line. Got to be really impressed with Randy Shannon's effort in recruiting the last two or three years since he's been here as a head coach in bringing in top-notch defensive linemen.
Deflected, hit the ground. Eldridge tried to catch it on the ricochet. The line judge saw that it had hit the ground and it was incomplete. He came running in.
Pretty good heads up, though, by Eldridge. Ball comes out and tries to get his hands underneath there. Actually had a hold of the football there, but it clearly went through his hands for the incompletion.
And we've got an injured Kane. I believe that's Smith down on the field. Andrew Smith and clutching that right knee. As we take a look at our Pacific Life game summary, we began the night talking about the backup quarterback of Oklahoma, Landry Jones, and of course Jacory Harris of the Canes. And look how Harris has picked it up.
The two interceptions early in the game for Harris, costly. One of them led to a touchdown. But as you said, he's really seems to have settled down. And also Mark Whipple, I think, as a play caller, making some adjustments. We were looking at halftime at the passing chart for Jacory Harris. And early in the game, if you look to see, they were trying to go downfield. And then they made the adjustment and started to attack the Oklahoma linebackers.
Now remember what's on the sideline for Oklahoma tonight. Let's not overlook the Heisman Trophy winning quarterback. Ryan Broyles there to his left with the injured left shoulder. Both out with shoulder injuries. With Bradford, it is the right. And of course, they're without Jermaine Gresham. They're all American tight end. So that's how shorthanded this offense is. And right now, Landry Jones trying to keep this drive going. He faces a third and 10. Hand off to Brown. Penalty flag comes flying. And it is indeed that Kane front now bringing the heat.
What's interesting about the Canes defensive line starting to bring the heat and take this thing over is you would think that they would be the ones beginning to wear down in the second half against this up-tempo offense from Oklahoma. That has not been the case.
Sooners. Big Trent Williams, number 71, the All-American left tackle.
I was actually watching him, and he has a leg whip here in the back end. And the leg whip, I'm sure, is what the personal foul was all about on Moncur.
So the ball goes back the other side of midfield. Third down and a bunch. Canes continue to rush four. Incomplete. Caleb, the intended target.
Trying to find a seam there between the corner. Van Dyke and his safety, Ray Ray Armstrong. Caleb thought he got interfered with, but this is pretty good coverage. It's third and long. You're just trying to put it up and get it in between. Just hit that seam. No chance. And we've kind of had a little bit of jawing going back and forth, and now we've got a flag coming in here.
Unsportsmanlike conduct. Offense, number 29.
That's Chris Brown, the running back.
The biggest concern that Bob Stoops has when we talk about the personnel that he has lost coming into this game is leadership on the offensive side of the ball. That was exposed against BYU in the opening night. When you lose Bradford and you lose Gresham and you lose all those offensive linemen, who's the guy in the huddle that's going to step up? Now they're bringing both teams together here. to just try to, hey guys, let's have a good game here. Let's get aggressive, but let's keep our cool.
It's a Big 12 referee, Adrian Hill. His umpire is Tom Quick. Al Green, Rusty Baines, Bobby Abels, Eugene Hall, Scott Vaughn. That's your officiating crew. Way back in punt formation, standing close to his 20. Left foots it out. Fielded at the 27 by Benjamin. No daylight. Good coverage. The ACC against the Big 12. Timeout.
Saturday Night Football on ABC. Presented by Southwest Airlines. Go to southwest.com. Grab your bag. It's on. Dodge Ram, the truck that never backs down from a challenge. And Enterprise Rent-A-Car, we'll pick you up.
Landshark Stadium. Tonight, it is the Hurricanes with a home game. Tomorrow, the Miami Dolphins. And the sod is down at the Miami Marlins. They've closed out their baseball campaign here. Drops it off on first down to Mike James, the fullback. Let's take a look at this chart.
Yeah, we talked at the very first part of this game when he made some poor decisions. He got a little bit aggressive, went downfield. You can see only two throws across 15 yards, both interceptions. And since then, the adjustment has been to attack that aggressive underneath part of that Oklahoma defense where the safeties and the linebackers were really tuned in to attacking the running game, and it's paid off for him. He's only missed one pass, and he's also found a rhythm, and I think in the process has slowed Oklahoma's defense down.
Second down and three. And Cooper is short. Of course, it was last January when the coach's trophy presented by Dr. Pepper was awarded to the Florida Gators right here on this field. Next year, it will be awarded out in Pasadena at the Rose Bowl on the night of January 7th. The game we'll have on ABC. Both of these teams, of course, with dreams of getting there. Both have lost once. So a second loss tonight would certainly damage those dreams. James, the running back, on third and two. Harris drops it in underneath. And they pick up a first down with James circling out.
That's where you attack this Oklahoma defense. Remember last year we called the Texas OU game, and Colt McCoy had so much success in that area where the linebackers are so free-willing and aggressive. If you get time to throw, because they're so athletic and they get out of there so quickly, you have to try to be able to put receivers and running backs and tight ends into that void, and you can find some openings.
Brent Venables with his hands full now that Ja'Cory Harris has found that you can move the ball underneath against those linebackers and not try to probe so deep all the time. Here comes Cooper. Battles for a yard. Let's check in with Matt Weiner. Matt.
Hi, Brent. Let's get a Verizon Wireless update from the major leagues tonight. The Chicago White Sox beat the Tigers in Detroit 5-1. Here's the final out. Meanwhile, the Twins defeated Kansas City 5-4. The Twins and Tigers enter tomorrow's final day of the regular season in a flat-footed first-place tie in the AL Central. A tiebreaker, if necessary, would be on Tuesday.
So the race comes down to the last day. Huh? The heat is on the Tigers. Looks like they had it a couple weeks ago, didn't it? Play fake now by Ja'Cory. Drops it off beautifully that time. Again to Epps, who scored the last touchdown coming out. What nice touch he demonstrated on this pass.
Play action pass. Ja'Cory Harris very comfortable. And again, mixing in the run with the pass. Slows the linebackers. Gives him time. And there's the same matchup you talked about with the touchdown. Not only Epps, but getting separation from Keenan Clayton, who was covering him when he scored the touchdown.
Look what I found. Whipple calling the plays and Ja'Cory Harris pulling the trigger.
Those last 13 throws, not huge yards, but good decisions.
Here comes Cooper, hole on that left side, and he was quickly tripped up on it by Beal.
This is Mark Whipple's type of offense, and the offense that these players have come to really believe in and have confidence in. And what it does, what Mark Whipple ideally would like to do is give you so many different looks you don't know if it's going to be a run or a pass because he's breaking tendencies. And when he has the play action pass going with the running game, makes it very, very tough on the linebackers and guessing what might be coming next.
Here comes a linebacker blitz. Deflected. Incomplete. So Venables bringing a little more heat that time.
Interesting adjustment, Brent, this time is Austin English starts to come up, and then he drops up to the top of the screen, and now he's got his head on a swivel, and he's waiting for those small underneath passes. See why he's right there as a defensive end? Instead of rushing, they brought a blitz on the other side. He drops, and as soon as he dropped as a defensive end, his head's on a swivel. He's looking for a crossing route, and he looked up the running back. That's a way you can take that away.
Meanwhile, Beal deflected the ball as English had dropped off into that route. Third down and 7, and a timeout has been called by the Hurricanes. Miami leading by 4. 7:01 left in the third quarter. 4 in purple. And it'll be Brett Favre playing Green Bay up in the Metrodome. Now Ja'Cory Harris for the Canes. Gonna strike deep, got a man wide open. Touchdown, Benjamin! His third scoring strike of the night. This one to the wide out. The freshman Travis Benjamin for 38 yards. That was so well set up, Herbie, by that underneath stuff that they were doing. Whipple had him primed for that.
That's exactly what happens, Brent, is you get so caught up in thinking about the underneath and the short throws. You get lulled to sleep a little bit on the deeper throw, and I think it may have been a broken coverage as well.
Bosher tacks on the extra point. We're talking about a real cool customer right here. Herbie Benjamin scores, but I think we have located the problem with this piece of tape.
Dominique Franks making some mistakes, and Bob Stoops right now talking to Keenan Clayton. Miscommunication on this Oklahoma defense, costly at a huge point in his football game. First, Bob went to Dominique Franks, the defensive back who was over top of Benjamin, and then he talked to Keenan Clayton.
Uribe with the kickoff fielded at the 9-yard line. And Madu is short of the 20, and the Canes are some kind of fired up right now.
At the bottom of the screen, actually, here, isolated, Travis Benjamin moves just to the inside, and I think there's nobody there, so clearly you have a defensive back in Dominique Franks who should have been with him. There's a mix-up in coverage. Clayton actually comes on a blitz. You got to wonder if he should have been involved there. But nobody's in the deep middle of the defense. Very, very easy for a quarterback like Ja'Cory Harris to make that throw. And that's when Dominique Franks came off the field. That's exactly what he got.
This will change the Sooners' approach. Down 21-10, 6:48 to go. There was movement.
Before the play clock expired, timeout Oklahoma. Their first and a half. This will be a 30-second timeout.
Things have gone awry. Well, 8:30 Monday night, we'll all be there. Rodgers and Favre. Favre taking on his old team. Played 16 seasons up in Green Bay. Number 4, so familiar. Now go back in history now and think of some of the number 4s that you have seen, that you have heard about. How about one for the Buckeyes?
Oh, you're beautiful.
Mr. Kirk Herbstreit himself.
Oh, yeah, me? That's Brett Favre. That makes some sense.
That was pretty good, though.
With the music, huh?
Hey, I'm a star with your children right now. I'm a hero now.
You are.
Boys, man.
They already love you.
Look at Pops up there with Favre.
They love you.
And the handoff, they keep this on the ground on first and 10.
If you're an Oklahoma fan watching this game right now, the reason you're uneasy is we've talked about this the entire football game. So much attention about Bradford not being in this game, but it's not about Bradford being in this game. Landry Jones is capable, but who's going to come along to help Landry Jones out? What wide receiver? Which of the offensive linemen? Somebody needs to help this guy out.
Firing for the first down. The gamble defensively is not good. And again, Kenny gets it done. He scored the touchdown. And he picks up yards after catch.
Kenny against Sam Shields. It's been a broken record. That's where they've had some success. And I think if I'm the quarterback, you're going to continue to look for that matchup. Anytime Kenny gets against Sam Shields, Sam Shields is looking for the big play.
Caleb out of bounds, close to the first down marker. Picked up probably about 9 yards as he stepped out there. 6:03 left in the third. So here's the young man from New Mexico trying to rally the Sooners from behind. They've already lost one game. To the 38, wants a face mask on top of it.
This offense is predicated upon picking up first downs and getting the tempo going. It's the first time in about 4 or 5 possessions that we've seen Oklahoma getting up to the line of scrimmage and getting this Miami defense on its heels.
Might have a case. There's going to be face mask adjustment on the sideline. And now timeout has been called by the Canes.
Timeout, Miami, their second of the half. This will be a 30-second timeout.
So here is 43-year-old Randy Shannon, who played linebacker at Miami, bringing his team over the sideline. And he is such a wonderful story. I cannot stress enough what he has brought to this Canes program. Many of you know the story. At the age of 3, his father was murdered here in South Florida. So to this day, he has a team rule. If you are found with a gun, you're off the team. No excuses, no exceptions. No waiting for a trial. And Dave Hyde, the fine writer for the Sun Sentinel here, chronicled Randy Shannon's background. At the age of 10, his twin brothers became addicted to crack cocaine and both died. And here's a young man who survived the mean streets. Came up, got himself an education, became an assistant coach with Miami. Here he is as the head coach, doing things the right way. Folks, do you know how many Canes have been arrested under his watch? One. Only one. Doing it the right way. 21-10 right now. Miami and Shannon with the lead. 5.5 minutes left here in the third. And Miami was not charged with a timeout in that stoppage. And Murray, because of the Oklahoma substitution before that on the other side. So
whatever the reason for the timeout, it was almost like you're calling a game with Steve Lavin and a team needs to get a 20 just to kind of gather themselves and try to kill a rally. Right now, Oklahoma, this is what they're feeding off of, this energy.
Here comes Murray trying to get the corner. Battling his way for that first down.
You're going to get another hold.
Holding offense number 7. 10-yard penalty. Second down.
That right tackle with Jarvis Jones before and this time Corey Brandon has really caused Oklahoma some problems. It's Ray Ray Armstrong on that collision with DeMarco Murray.
Well, he's being tended to, and reminder that MetLife is providing today's aerial coverage. So visit MetLife.com to learn more about MetLife's long history of providing coverage at major sporting events.
Corey Brandon, I thought it was a contact from the running back. It's actually Corey Brandon gets called for the holding, and then look what he does in the end. See 26 in the middle of the screen, plays almost over. Boom! Brandon comes in from behind. Didn't get called for a penalty, but should have. It's a double whammy there on Corey Brandon.
Second down and 14. Back in the pistol.
incomplete. You know, it's interesting when you look at Miami here, Herbie. They have played arguably the toughest schedule in the FBS this year. This is the fourth-ranked team. They were ranked when they played this month. No other team in ACC history has opened against four ranked teams. And here they are going toe-to-toe. Beaten by one of them, Virginia Tech, on a rainy, tough day at Lane Stadium last Saturday. Landry Jones. And again, he comes back to Hannah for the second time in this sequence.
John Lovett, the defensive coordinator from Miami, putting together a heck of a plan. And I know Oklahoma is shorthanded tonight, but just making good decisions, getting in a lot of players to avoid cramps and things like this, maybe from Sean Spence. But these third and longs are being smart, not taking a lot of chances, just keeping the ball in front of them, giving Landry Jones the only throw, dumping it underneath, and then corralling him and keeping him well short of the first down.
Check it down below with Lisa. Lisa?
Hey, Brent, well, you guys have been talking about how Miami's defense is holding up against Oklahoma's up-tempo offense. Well, they prepared for it by having two huddles running at them all week in practice. So they would have run one play against one offensive group when the ball was whistled down. Another offensive group would step up to the line ready to go. And defensive coordinator John Lovett was saying, as Kirk said, that it was a grueling pace, but actually a little bit faster than what they're facing out here tonight. Guys?
Another thing, 5:30 in the morning workouts. That'll get you.
That'll do it.
John Chaney at Temple. Coach, yeah. I don't think I'd be attending any of your practices.
Right.
He was great.
That's one way to get their attention.
Oh, yes.
Sure thing, it's dark out.
So Way is back to punt.
Yep, got it.
Inside the 5-yard line, but I believe they ran into the punter. If this is just running in, this was about a 4th and 10.
Wow,
that's
foul.
Personal foul.
Wow.
That's
defense,
big.
Number 91. He hit the kicker's plant leg. 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
Joe Joseph and Shannon can't believe it.
Big Joe Joseph comes in and actually gets some pretty good pressure. He splits the wall there. Wow, that's. I don't know, you and I sometimes disagree.
What do you want me to go first?
He falls on the ground and then he, I don't know. That's running into. To me, you have to come down in the air and come through the punter. He landed on the ground first and then skidded into the punter. What do you say? What do you say, friend? What do you got? Look, he's smiling because he did such a good job. He's happy. He's proud of himself. He should be.
I'll let you off the hook. First down, continue. Swinging out of DeMarco Murray. 20. Cross first down. Dives for the end zone. Just out of bounds. Going to be marked, it looks like, at around the almost the 3-yard line.
Look at the blocks here by Hannah, 82. Picks up one big block. Caleb right there picks up a nice block. And that gave DeMarco Murray a little bit of room to run, and he almost takes it into the end zone. But great perimeter blocking that time by the Sooners.
Big Matt Clamp comes in to lead the way for Murray. Murray for the end zone for Oklahoma touchdown. Well, the big play there.
Huge
with
play.
Roughing the punter. An automatic first down kept him alive. And two plays later, DeMarco nails it. The offensive lineman shaking up. So let's take one more look here.
Yeah. Whether it was the right call or not, the call was made. Set this up. Two plays later, Murray pounds it in and picks up a huge touchdown. But whether they caught a break there or not, let's just talk about this offense. For the first time in about 5 drives, they got up to the line of scrimmage and attacked Randy Shannon's defense that time. Created the tempo. And the way you do that is you pick up that initial first down, and that usually will start them to get them going.
Jeffries was shaken up, but he appears to be okay. Stevens tacks on the extra point.
So let's go to Matt Weiner in New York for an update, Matt.
All right, Brad, let's get a check of the primetime pulse. That newfangled Auburn offense is starting to get a little separation at Tennessee. Now 23-6 there, that game on ESPN. On ESPN2, Ryan Mallett has 4 touchdown passes for Arkansas. They now lead A&M 40-19. That game again on ESPN2 and ESPN360.com at Cowboys Stadium.
A&M, welcome to college football in the 2009 season. Putting up some big numbers. Take on the old Razorbacks. How about War Eagle?
War Eagle.
Yeah, Randy is not happy with Joseph. First thing he said when Joseph came over, why? Didn't even have the block set up, obviously. Look at the score at the top of the screen. Still, Miami up 4. It's not the end of the world. You gave up a touchdown. Now you got to show, act like you've been here before. Keep playing football.
Fielded at the 8-yard line by James. James has spun out of bounds. Well, Flash Forward is a new show coming on ABC this fall. Let's flash forward to next week. Kirk and I'll be in Iowa City for ABC's Saturday Night Football. Michigan takes on Iowa at 8 Eastern. And there you have the Iowa Hawkeyes 5-0 overall, and the Badgers and the Buckeyes leading the conference. Michigan with a tough overtime loss at East Lansing. Great comeback by the Wolverines.
K4CA taking over those last 5 minutes, but I think the story has to be Iowa and Wisconsin and what the Badgers and the Hawkeyes have been able to do here in these first 5 games.
Now to Corey Harris and the Kane offense. Javarius James takes the toss. Jammed up on that side, cuts it back all by himself and picks up a couple of yards.
We'll get back to Ja'Cory Harris and this attack with Mark Whipple. They've had a lot of success running the football and the play action, the underneath throws. Brent Venables, Oklahoma's defensive coordinator, trying to make adjustments, trying to maintain their aggressiveness that has allowed them to play so well throughout most of this game. But the Canes have done a nice job of countering with their attack.
Blitz takes the sack at the 34-yard line. Jeremy Beal again.
Well, they took on the blitz. The initial surge they were able to hold, but Beal comes from his left defensive end spot around to the middle and had enough time. He did give coverage, the coverage there, an assist because Harris actually had enough time there to throw the football, but because of the outstanding coverage, Beal was able to lower the boom.
Sacked 3 times tonight, hurried 3 and hit 2 other times. He is overall 15 of 19 for 155, 3 touchdowns and 2 early interceptions. High, look out, almost a pick 6. Franks, who intercepted the first one of the game for the Sooners, had a hand on it as Ja'Cory floated that one.
That reminded me of his throw against Virginia Tech in Blacksburg, where it was a long throw to his right. The Virginia Tech defensive back stepped in front of it. This would have been a great play. Franks reads it, has time to be able to get in front of it. And obviously, if he brings that down, Oklahoma takes the lead.
Now Matt Bosher back to punt. And Franks will go back. Booming high punt. Fair catch, runs over to the 22-yard line and out of bounds. Well, ABC Comedy Wednesday, the number one new night for comedy, and at 9, 8 Central, Modern Family is the number one new comedy. See for yourself why all of America can't stop laughing and talking about ABC's Modern Family. That's on Comedy Wednesday, 9, 8 Central.
You've been all over Dancing with the Stars this year?
Absolutely. You're right.
Mike Irvin still on board?
He's going to win it.
You think he's going to win it?
You're talking to me?
First down and 10. Waits the pass to Kenny. Kenny has been a busy receiver here tonight. Half dozen for 71 yards and a touchdown.
You and I thinking a lot. I was thinking the same thing. He has really stepped up tonight.
Here's Brown. Short of the 30-yard line.
Seems like the Sooners go from about third gear to fifth gear once they pick up that initial first down. And Miami seems to lose that attitude where they pin their ears back once the Sooners pick up a first down. He's got soft coverage again at the top of the screen with his guy that's had a big night tonight, Cameron Kenny.
Under pressure, hit on the release, incomplete. And that was Mankur who took him down.
Mankur has that speed that we've seen tonight. It's nice to see him healthy. He's missed some games this year. Probably when he's healthy, their best pass rush man. And he's not going up against a rookie there. He's going up against an all-conference tackle in Trent Williams, and he just beat him to the edge with that burst.
Want to bet Joseph doesn't run into him this time?
He's not even in there.
Like I said.
Wait.
On back into the end zone. So we look about on the 20-yard line. That's a 71-yard punt.
Helps the average. What do you think of the mustache? What do you think of that?
Fear of the stash. Looks like a gunfighter out of New Mexico. Name a land.
Done a good job, you know.
Outstanding job.
Done a great job. And now I see why Bob Stoops and Kevin Wilson said, "Hey guys, it's not about Landry Jones. We've seen enough from him to believe in him. It's about what's around him."
Play fake. Ja'Cory wants to probe deep on the deflection. Benjamin catches it. Oh baby, that could have been pick number 3.
He's willing to take chances. I think he might have been throwing it to Epps coming across the middle. It goes over him. How about the focus by Travis Benjamin to lock in and make that catch? When you're the quarterback, of course, he meant that. It's a great throw. Good read. It's eyeing 3 the whole way.
Come back quickly with the other James, and that's Mike James, the fullback, the first time that they have lined him up in the eye and then hit that quick hitter. Time running out here in the third quarter. Got a 4-point game.
Got a war here. It's a good ball game.
You bet.
It's going to be a great fourth quarter.
Hasn't the whole season been good, though?
Oh, gosh.
Who knows what you're going to get. This presentation is Saturday Night Football, presented by Southwest Airlines. We'll return after this message and a word from our ABC stations. We welcome you back on a beautiful Saturday night here in South Florida. 4-point game, 21-17. You know, he was thinking about Brett Favre, Herbie, and you got to go back to 1992 when he started that great streak. He hasn't missed an NFL weekend starting as a quarterback since, well, he missed his last one back on September 20th. He started the streak September 27th. So here's your bonus question. Who were the starting quarterbacks at Oklahoma and Miami when Brett Favre started that streak? Ding, 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 ding. Here we go now. Hand off to start the fourth quarter.
You ready?
And that's James across midfield. Go ahead.
1992?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Well, I know Gino Toretta.
You got
obviously.
It. Bingo. OU.
Oh, my gosh.
Dun, 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 dun. First and 10 now. I told you I had a tougher
give me a play here. Come on now.
All right, you get a play. First down and 10. He's near midfield.
got it. Got it.
Here's a handoff now to Cooper, who came in as the running back, still battling straight ahead and stopped. And here comes Mr. Herbstre with the answer.
Cale Gundy.
Genius.
Woo!
Genius. There he is.
Yes, sir.
One of the assistant coaches on the OU staff when Brett Favre started that amazing streak of his, that endurance streak. He was a quarterback. Toretto, of course, at Miami, won the Heisman. Bill Clinton, number one sog end of the road. And how about Clint Eastwood in Unforgiven? Now, there was a Cowboy, and Mr. Herbstreit was starting the quarterback
for
the Buckeyes.
Into the road by Boyz II Men. You were all over that one.
Yes, indeed. Second down and seven. Keeping it on the ground. The will to run with Cooper. Whipple told us in the meeting yesterday that at some point in this game, they were going to have to run against Oklahoma. The old Dick Vermeil theory. You got to make a commitment.
Big third down here, Brent. You know, the balance has been admirable. Miami, 44 plays, 23 runs, and 21 passes. Remember, they've had some success finding the tight ends, looking underneath, trying to attack the linebackers on some big third downs.
Here comes a blitz. Of course, incomplete. I think he had Benjamin there for a second.
Give Oklahoma some credit there. Dominique Franks bringing his coverage up tight. Sometimes in college football, for whatever reason, on third down, we do games every week, and you see corners who on third and six might give an 8 to 10 yard cushion, making an easy throw. This time Franks comes up and eliminates the cushion, is there to knock that ball away.
Boxer back to punt. Franks standing just inside the, right at the Sooner 10, actually. There is a flag, a fair catch signal for the 9 yard line, but there is a flag thrown by the line judge. Stoops wants him punting again.
Yeah, he doesn't want to start the ball at the 9 yard line. Take his
illegal
chance
formation,
on another
one. Offense. More than four players in the backfield. Number one was not on the line of scrimmage. 5 yard penalty. Replay fourth down.
Mosher has a big leg. See what he comes up with here on the repunt. Franks moves up 5 yards, standing about the 14 and 15. Almost got a piece of it, didn't he? Takes a Cain bounce.
Gain of four.
Yep. Well, a reminder, Brett Favre and the Minnesota Vikings, 8:30 Monday night against his old team, Green Bay. Reminder to stay tuned for the Ford wrap-up coming up right after this game. It's a happy address right now. But the Sooners come back. They've got the football, trailing it by four. Update from the West Coast, USC 23, Cal nothing. Fourth quarter score. 12 and a half minutes. Back in the pistol. Time, Madu to the 18-yard line on first down. You know, Herbie, thinking about Sam Bradford being over there in street clothes and having won the Heisman last year, and of course Tim Tebow shaking up. That race within the race, we'll get into that here in just a second. We got second and four. Here come the penalty flags coming down.
Prior to the snap, both start offense, number 61. 5-yard penalty, still second down.
There's Sam, but there's a name that I think we've got to add to at least the discussion. Toby Gerhart.
Oh, yeah.
Of Stanford. They are 3-0 in Pac-10 play. He had three touchdowns and leads the Pac-10 in rushing. So maybe the best running back that nobody's heard of this year. Second down and 9. Jones in trouble. Slips the tackle. Incomplete. And a penalty flag again. We've had a little yellow tonight. This will be the 18th penalty of the game.
Jeez. We've had a ton of them. Well, obviously holding going to be on Oklahoma here.
Holding offense, number 76. That penalty is declined. Third down.
Once again, between Jarvis Jones and Corey Brandon, the right tackle spot again. Hurting Oklahoma. This one's declined, though.
They'll run, and Big Joe Joseph just ate it up.
How about Joe Joseph coming off this block, making amends for that roughing of the punter, and a big third down on the draw. Does a great job right in the middle of this defense. Sheds the block and makes the play in the backfield for Miami. Fired up Joe Joseph.
Benjamin will go back deep. Way from the Sooner end zone. Penalty flag flies immediately.
I was hoping that was a beanbag.
After the possible 18th was declined, this will
kick,
not be.
Holding receiving team number 8. 10-yard penalty from the end of the kick. First down. Timeout.
10:53. Miami clinging to a 4-point lead over Oklahoma.
Saturday Night Football on ABC, presented by Southwest Airlines. Go to southwest.com. Grab your bag. It's on. Nissan Maxima, proud partner of the Heisman Trophy. And Taco Bell. Think outside the box.
We hit the top of the hour, 11 o'clock on the East Coast. The beauty of Saturday Night Football, you can sleep in tomorrow. 10:53 remaining in regulation, a 4-point game. Here's James as we take a look at the Pacific Life game summary. And Herbie, I just don't think we can make enough of young Ja'Cory Harris coming back from those two early interceptions.
Two interceptions on the first two possessions of the game where he got a little anxious and took some shots downfield. Since has settled down, obviously, with the three touchdowns. And, you know, Landry Jones' numbers aren't enormous, but he's been very smart and he's made some good decisions to keep Oklahoma, that's a depleted offense, still in this game.
Comes a blitz. Dropped. Incomplete. Johnson should have had it. We'd like to welcome those of you who've been watching USC beat up on Cal. Here we have a Miami 21, Oklahoma 17 game. Now the Sooners scored the first 10 points of the game, but Miami's outscored them since then, 21-7. We have 10:14 to go. Sam Bradford not playing tonight for Bob Stoops. Landry Jones. And this is the Kane offense with Ja'Cory Harris, who overcame two interceptions on their first two series. He's thrown three touchdown passes. He now faces a 3rd and 9. And Venables is bringing heat.
Okay.
First down.
The young man who dropped it, Johnson, his high school teammate from Northwestern High in Miami.
And a great job by Miami's offensive line. The zone pressure comes from the right. They give him just enough time to allow Johnson to get finished with his cut. And again, the anticipation in the field between two players that played together in high school, perfect timing, and the time that he had to throw was essential for Harris.
The turnaround by the youngster. Breaking out is James. Picks up a first down. So offensive coordinator Whipple bringing the run right straight at him.
This is a great job of not stopping. Looking for the young running backs out there. There's a senior that's showing you never to give up on a play. It looks like it's Stone at the line of scrimmage. He keeps moving his feet. Next thing you know, he's still up. He finds a little crease, and he gets downfield for a first down. Good effort that time by Javaris James. It's over 100 yards on the night.
An offensive line coming off by far its worst performance of the season against Virginia Tech. Tonight, this Hurricane offensive line has done one heck of a job against a very good defensive front. A little bit high, incomplete. Epps, the tight end, who scored one of the touchdowns. The five guys up front for the Canes here today have really answered the bell.
Looks like a different group from a week ago.
Absolutely.
And they went up to Lane Stadium to take on Virginia Tech, where they struggled against Bud Foster's defense.
Of course, one of the things, and the fellas getting ready to play Sunday certainly know this, if you're an offensive lineman, you love to sit down and take the run at somebody and not have to back up. If you fall behind early in a game, way back, you just got to pull back and pass block all game long. You get worn out by those wrestlers. Ja'Cory goes deep, end zone, incomplete. Theron Collier diving forward inside the five.
Well, he had it. Look at this little inside move and a go, and he catches Quentin Carter peeking, and he had him beat. Well thrown ball and a great effort by Collier, but he gave him just a little inside move, and he got separation because Carter started to come up. And if he puts just a little bit more air underneath that, Collier might run underneath that for a touchdown. Nice move there.
One of the beauties of that throw is you could not intercept it. It was either going to be a great catch, but they weren't going to pick it. Third down and 10. Hankerson. Number 85 in motion. In trouble. Beal closing in. At the 41-yard line, down goes Ja'Cory.
So Ja'Cory Harris still shows his youth in taking this sack on third down and long. Once he gets 5 yards outside where the ball is snapped, right about there, he could throw the football away. Instead of taking this significant loss, right here, you get to the outside, throw it away before Beal can close in on you, and you take the big loss.
That's the fourth sack by the Sooners front, and that one's for 16, and it brings Bosher back. And he drives Franks back, all the way back to the 1 yard line. He's going to try to do something with it. Down the sideline, breaking out toward midfield, and finally out of bounds. That's one of those, if you're going to do it and you're going to get close to the coaches, make it a good one. If you're going to field a punt on the 2 yard line. Way to go, Stoops just said. Great job. Time out.
Brent, this breaks every coaching rule in the book. Catches inside the 1 yard line, goes back into the end zone. Then he shows his great athletic ability. But how about the risk, the decision making that time by Franks? It works out. Oh boy, almost disaster for the Sooners.
Saving tackle by Bosher, the punter. Franks gambles, brings it back 51 yards. Flag. One thing to keep in mind now about the Oklahoma offense, their last two possessions now, both of them have been three and out.
Prior to the snap, offside defense, number 99, 5 yard penalty, still first down.
Forston. And a reminder to stay tuned after the game for your late local news over most of these ABC stations. Over on ESPN, tune over to SportsCenter for post game analysis as well as today's scores and highlights. And there have been a couple of dangers.
Well, after the penalty, a little bit more manageable here. First and five. Murray. First down, Oklahoma. Close to the 30-yard line. Trailing by four here inside of 8 minutes in the fourth quarter.
Thing you love about these college games that go into the fourth quarter, coaches are always preaching about finish, finish, and work ethic. It's on the line here.
Murray battling. He's certainly finishing right now.
Absolutely. This is what Oklahoma's wanted to see from DeMarco Murray this year. The fact that they know that he's capable of being physical and also explosive. I mean, he has some rare ability, the combination of power and speed. Love to see him take a game over like this.
Again, slipped short of the first down.
Right now, they're just getting behind the left side, which is the strongest part of the offensive line. And following that big fullback, Matt Clapp, who's picking up a block on a linebacker, and they're getting behind Trent Williams, and they're trying to get their yards on that left side, just getting physical.
His helmet across for the first down to the 20-yard line.
That's where you say, you know we're going to run left. We know we're going to run left. Can you stop us?
Big Trent Williams over there, the left tackle. Brian Simmons, the left guard for Scoops. He was the right tackle a year ago with that great veteran offensive line. Now they've had to replace three.
Secondary, be careful of the play action and trying to get behind them.
Chris Brown checks in as the running back. And he is jumped by Robinson.
Well, the right side of Oklahoma's offensive line, they have struggled tonight against Marcus Robinson and the defensive line, to the speed that they've had to deal with from the Canes. The linebacker, Sean Spence, getting a lot of penetration off that right side. If you're Oklahoma and you need to be able to get some yards running, you know you need to try to get it on that left side.
Power eye.
Look how many orange jerseys are up at the line of scrimmage. Great time for play action.
Brown. He's thrown for a loss. McCarthy had a big game last week against Virginia Tech.
They're overloading. Miami's overloading Oklahoma's left side. And Oklahoma's trying to count the numbers and on pre-snap and run to the right. The problem is they're not winning the battles on the right-hand side. Miami's winning that battle.
Third and 12, tried to hit DeMarco Murray. He slips again and is short. It'll bring up a fourth down. Remember, the Sooners are down by four. The young defensive backs will have to remember that they ain't kicking any field goal here. Check that. They were right. I was wrong.
You never know.
With 4:32, he's already faked one. At fourth down. This will be a 39-yarder and a timeout.
Timeout, Miami, their second of the half. This will be a 30-second timeout.
Well, now you start to think Miami calls the timeout, and does Bob Stoops start to reevaluate with 4:23 to go? He's got a little bit of time to think about things and start to think about the timeouts. And Sean Spence in the middle of the screen, still buckling his chin strap, out of position. That's why the ball was snapped so quickly. But when DeMarco Murray went down, and anyway, Ray Armstrong's out there to make the play, but they had the numbers off to the left there.
You know, actually, on second thought, when you think about what they'd have to get a first down, and you're down by four.
How about this?
And you've got a defense. I think you have to go ahead and kick this.
I think you kick the field goal. Yeah. You assume that Miami's going to get very conservative and run the football three straight times.
Right.
you're going to be able to stop the clock twice. You're going to have to let the clock continue after the third one, and then you try to get into field goal range and win it. You can see that logic for sure.
When he faked it, it was only fourth and two, and now, you know, he's looking at a fourth and 11. That's a lot different.
You got to hit this.
Slips it through. And, of course, that sets it up to win it with a field goal. So there's no second-guessing that move on Stoops' part. That was very sound. Timeout. Well, we want to thank MetLife for providing today's dramatic coverage. Hope you've enjoyed this game. And MetLife has the protection you need for the most important ifs in your life. Visit MetLife.com today. 4:18 remaining. A one-point game. Moreland to kick it off for the Sooners. Fielded at the four-yard line by Cooper. Now to the 27, and now to Matt Weiner in our Times Square studios in New York for an update, Matt.
Thank you, Brent. Time for an AT&T All-America Player of the Week update. Notre Dame's Golden Tate had the second-best receiving day in school history. 244 yards on 9 catches and a touchdown in the Irish's overtime win over Washington. To cast your vote, text the word vote to 345-345 from your mobile phone.
And here are Greg Cooper, the return man, shaken up. That means that James will have to come on as the running back. And, of course, a reminder, the chase for the Sprint Cup continues tomorrow. ABC, 1 Eastern, 10 out in the Pacific. We'll see if Mark Martin can hold up. Jimmy Johnson, 10 out. Juan Pablo Montoya has had a great year, 65 points out of the lead. And Cooper still being tended to, which would put the Canes just a touch shorthanded at that running back position, but he's coming off under his own power and looks like he's fine.
Seems like the second half, I don't know if it's the cramping, the humidity. Both teams, we've had a lot of players walking off the field, many of them returning, some not, but just seems that between the flags tonight, the penalties, and the number of players that we've had, it's been a hard-hitting football game on both sides. This is it, 4 minutes, 10 seconds. Still, this game long way from being decided.
Ja'Cory Harris with Mark Whipple, who was on the coaching staff a year ago of the Philadelphia Eagles, with Andy Reid. They will make the decisions. Fake on a toss, wide open on that first play. Drops it off to Johnson. A well-schemed play.
What?
Dialed up by Whipple.
A call by Mark Whipple. We're assuming that they're going to run the football, so they show a little action to the right. Sets up an easy throw, so it's a high percentage throw coming back to Johnson. If he could have just stayed in bounds, it would have made that much more sense. But you got to love the aggressive call that time by Mark Whipple. But Johnson's got to stay in bounds.
You can see Donovan McNabb rolling out of that play, can't you?
Yeah.
340. And clock down and handing off. James breaks free, crosses midfield, spins 45, and he's down to the 39-40-yard line of the Sooners here with 3:20 to go.
With the Sooners attacking downhill with their linebackers, when you make it through the initial surge right there, there's already 8 jerseys up at the line of scrimmage. So if you're James, if you can make it through that initial surge right there, you've got room to run, and he made the Sooners pay for it right there. Nice job up front by the Canes.
And a timeout is being called by Stoops and the Sooners. When you look at the total yards here tonight, Miami 321, 127 on the ground, and 194 through the air. Oklahoma with 341 yards. The Sooners, of course, shorthanded because of injuries. They lost Broyles in the first half of this game. Now Whipple with 325. To work with, and Oklahoma down to its last timeout.
We've talked so much tonight about Ja'Cory Harris, but when you can get a night like this from Javaris James, just works hand in hand with the play action play calling that they want to get from Ja'Cory Harris.
of you from the Pacific. Miami leading Oklahoma by a point, 21-20. Here is Jarvis James, the running back. 136 yards here tonight behind an offensive line that was widely criticized after last Saturday's loss up in Blacksburg at the hands of Virginia Tech. These guys were under fire all week long down here in South Florida. Fox, Franklin, Trump, Figueroa, and Pippo, they have done a fabulous job here tonight. Second down and 7, 2:49. Oklahoma desperately needing the ball back. And again, a steady dot. But this time, the Sooners stop it. Reynolds, middle linebacker.
Sooners used their last time out, making this 3rd and 6. The ball game here for Bob Stoops. They've got to come up with a stop here on this 3rd down.
The entire world blacked out. Everyone saw a vision of their own future. Now the race is on to discover why. The most talked about new drama of the fall season. ABC's Flash Forward, all new this Thursday at 8, 7 Central on ABC. Well, quite a day in college football as LSU rallies against Georgia, Notre Dame in overtime over Washington. How about Jake Locker, the Husky quarterback, and what he's done this year? Are you aware that last month the California Angels paid Locker $300,000 to play center field? They didn't even know if he wants to play baseball again in 2 years. That means that they're paying for his scholarship out there, but he took Notre Dame into overtime. You'll see the highlights on ESPN right after this game. 21-20 now, Miami with a 1-point lead, 2.5 minutes.
Does Whipple run the football here to keep the clock moving, or does he get aggressive here potentially trying to pick up this first down and throw with his young quarterback?
Well, Whipple wants the timeout. With Andy Reid in the Eagles, or before that he was with the Steelers, it's automatic you got to throw when you face a 3rd and 6. But a little more of a decision to make at the college game, especially the way they've run the ball here.
You know that Oklahoma is going to put everybody right up the line of scrimmage. Linebackers attacking, safeties up close. If you're able to take the risk for the way they did on the first play and roll Harris out away from that pressure, give him a chance to either just throw a high percentage throw or just run the football to stay in bounds.
Mike James, 22, is the young fullback. He'll be in front of Javaris. Play action, they're going to throw it. Got the first down. Epps coming off that tight end spot. When in doubt, go to the tight end. And Ja'Cory says that's the play we wanted.
Nice job here. Again, the linebackers came up. They're expecting run. There's no way Miami's going to throw this. And Epps slips right behind the linebackers. Nice patience and poise once again from Ja'Cory Harris. Sits in there with time to throw and finds his man Epps again. Epps doesn't have a lot of catches, but the catches he has made tonight have been significant for this offense.
Oklahoma out of timeouts. The idea here from Whipple is to keep it running. James breaks free to the 14-yard line.
After you give up a huge 3rd down, this Miami offense is feeling good, and the Oklahoma defense is down. And Miami attacks him here. Look at the blocking. We've talked all night about this offensive line. One of them, the helmet pops off. Javaris James running like a madman tonight. 15 carries, 150 yards. I tell you, those first 4 games in August look pretty daunting. 2-2 look pretty good to me. They're going to sit here at 3-1.
Wow.
Miami on the verge of a big upset over Oklahoma. And Oklahoma's last three games outside of Norman have not gone well. Here tonight, then BYU on Dallas way to open this season. And of course, last January, right here, the national championship. Tonight, they were without their Heisman Trophy winner again for the third straight week. Ja'Cory Harris, Randy Shannon, and the Canes have done it. A huge win for the ACC as well.
Thing I wanted to see from Miami after their big start at 2-0, how would they respond after what happened in Blacksburg? And I think they showed America that this Miami team is a very, very talented team.
Let's go down below now to Lisa.
Thanks, Brent. I'm with Ja'Cory Harris. Ja'Cory, the play of the game was that completion on that last drive, 3rd and 6. Describe the play for me and what happened.
Well, the play was just the basic play action. We knew that they was going to draw to the run. But we knew that we were going to have something coming behind them, so we just ran a simple drag with a play action, and, you know, it just came successful.
Now, you started off the game with 2 interceptions on the first 2 possessions. What were you thinking after that?
Man, you know, stuff happens. You know, you come through, you got the jitters, but at the same time, my offense and, you know, my defense stood behind me. Everybody patted me on my back and told me they know that's not me, and I just had to step it up and, you know, make up on.
Now, when did things start really clicking for you? When did things start really clicking for you?
Oh, you know, when the offense really started getting behind me, everybody just came and gave me support. And I just said, man, around the second quarter, man, I got to do this. I got to be the one to step up and lead them.
Now, I see on the side of your head, it says you swag. What does that mean?
It's just you swag. You know, I'm not trying to be too confident or arrogant, but that's something we got to bring back to the program.
All right, thanks, and congratulations.
All right,
Lisa, they invented swagger. So against 4 ranked teams, they come out 3-1. A fabulous opening month by the Miami Hurricanes as we turn the page to November now. In the thick of things, and Ja'Cory Harris, one of the fine young quarterbacks in the country. Once again, our final score, 21-20, Miami beats back Oklahoma. Next Saturday, Herbie, you and I will be in Iowa City for Saturday Night Football on ABC. Michigan will take on Iowa. It's a Big Ten showdown at 8 p.m. Eastern. Now, let's take it to Times Square now for the Ford wrap-up. Here is Matt Weiner.